Hello everyone, welcome to East Notes, the place with the perfect science lessons, and today I'm here with a really interesting science chapter, which is light. And what's going to be special about this video is that since this is an experiment oriented chapter, I'm going to be conducting experiments. So that you don't have to refer anything else, everything you require is going to be in this video. So watch this video till the end without skipping any part of it. Let's begin. Alright. Light. Light is a form of energy which enables us to see things. And the properties of light. We have the rectilinear propagation of light. Light travels in a straight line. Now if I give you a straight pipe and a curved pipe and I place a candle in front of you, you can see the candle through the straight pipe, but you cannot see it through the curved pipe. Why? Because this is the rectilinear propagation of light. No matter what happens, light will never pass through a curved path. It will stop there, but it won't go through a curved path. Then we have the reflection of light. Light changes its direction when it strikes a shiny surface. So any polished or shiny surface can act as a mirror. Basically, light changes its direction when it strikes a mirror. The change of direction of light by a mirror is known as reflection of light. You can use this as the definition of reflection. Let's move on to the next slide. Here we have the types of images. Now, different types of mirrors form different types of images. And we have real image and the virtual image. What is the difference between these two is that the real image can be obtained on another screen. Now, the thing is reflected on the mirror, and then again that can be transformed to some other screen, and the virtual image cannot be obtained on another screen, so it will be seen only on the mirror, not anywhere else. Then we have a fact that real image is always inverted and virtual image is always erect. Very easy to classify from this fact. Then we have the plane mirror, which is basically a plain shiny surface. Properties of image formed in a plane mirror. The first property is that the image formed is always erect. Erect means it's straight, it's not upside down. Okay? Not upside down, it is straight. Then the image formed is always the same size of the object. You take it front, you take it back, left, right, wherever you take it, the size is always going to be the same. Okay? So size does not change wherever you go. It is a virtual image. It cannot be obtained on another screen. Like I said, it can only be seen on the mirror. You cannot reflect it on a wall or some other screen. Then the image is at the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. And what this suggests is that the distance between the object and the mirror is equal to the distance between the image formed and a mirror. So this is based off many questions. I'm standing in front of the mirror at 4 cm, and where will my image be formed? It will be equidistant, which means the image formed will be 4 cm behind the mirror. Now if I move 1 cm away, which means I'll be standing at distance of 5 cm from the mirror, my image will also move back 1 cm, which means it will be formed 5 cm behind the mirror. So now this fact is used to make many questions. For example, person A is standing 5 cm in front of the mirror. What is the distance between person A and his image? So it will be 10 cm, because you have to double it, because one is the distance between the person and the mirror, and second is the distance between the mirror and the image. This is equidistant, so we have to double the distance person is standing from the mirror and you will get the answer. Then we have lateral inversion, which means the left side of your image appears right and right side appears left. Now a really important question formed using this lateral inversion property is that on an ambulance, the word ambulance is written from left to right. Why? Now the reason to this is that if it is written in a laterally inverted way on the ambulance, so in the driver's rear view mirror, the driver can see it in a proper way, because in the mirror, again it gets laterally inverted. So if on the ambulance it is written laterally inverted, when he sees on its mirror, again it gets rotated and he gets the proper word ambulance the way we are used to reading it. And if he sees that and he's blocking the way of the ambulance, he can give way to it, because it is our duty to give way to the ambulance so that we can save the life of the patient. The first property that we learned was that the image formed by a plane mirror is always erect. So as you can see, this chess piece, no matter where I take it, left, right, front, back, it doesn't become upside down. It is always straight. It is erect. The second fact we had learned was that the image is virtual. So the image formed in the plane mirror, you can't project on another screen. Then we learned that it is the same size. So I bring it very close, I take it far, the image is the same size as the size of the object. No matter where I take it, as you can see, it remains the same. Then we had learnt about the same distance. So this is that the distance between the image and the mirror is same as the distance between object and the mirror. So if I keep the chess piece on the first block of the chessboard, in the image also it is on the first block. If I take it behind, it goes the same distance back. So it is formed that much distance behind. The object is 3 blocks in the front and the image is 3 blocks behind the mirror. If I take it right, if I take it left, no matter where I take it, it's going to be the same distance. Alright, and the last thing we had learnt was lateral inversion, which means the right side of the object will appear left and the left side will appear right. That's all for today. If you like this video, hit the like button, share and subscribe to Instagram Notes. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified when I release a new video. And the part 2 of this chapter, Light, is coming out soon, where we'll be discussing the convex and concave mirrors. So keep a lookout for that one. Thank you for watching and have a good day.